3, 2, 1, release, release, release. And that is a full duration burn, folks. We are headed to space.
Billionaire Richard Branson made history yesterday when he and his crew successfully marked a new era in space exploration. He and his 5 crew members from his company Virgin Galactic launched more than 53 miles above the Earth in a small rocket plane, and that cleared the way for space tourists to start taking flight. Branson told my colleague NBC's Tom Costello in an exclusive interview after the trip that for him it was a dream come true.
So, Richard, congratulations. How are you?
I will come down with a bump soon.
Did it live up to your expectations and your hopes?
I've always dreamt about what it would be like to be in space looking back at this incredible Earth. It's impossible to describe just how magnificent it is.
And joining us now is NBC's Cal Perry, who is in New Mexico and former astronaut and current senior advisor at the Intrepid Museum, Mike Massimino. Big welcome to the both of you. So, Cal, Branson pulled it off. So walk us through what's next and when tourists could start actually paying for flights like this.
Yeah, look, and I've spent sort of the weekend appearing with astronauts like astronaut Massimino, who's going to tell you that this is a fairly normal thing, but it's kind of ridiculous when you think about Richard Branson strapping himself basically to a rocket, firing that rocket for 1 minute, going completely vertical until 53 and a half miles above the Earth. This was a lifelong dream for Sir Richard Branson. This is a man who has taken chances his entire life. He is a modern day Howard Hughes, a man by whose own admission, the first time he went skydiving, pulled the wrong cord, somebody who is a showman, and this was an intentional show. This is a man who is trying to sell tickets on this spacecraft, currently priced at $250,000 each. They're hoping to sort of roll that out early next year. This was very much a publicity action, and look, he succeeded 100% in the goal of getting the word out about Virgin Galactic and hopefully opening up a new era in space tourism, Geoff.
And Mike, what about that? I mean, is there sort of any scientific value to any of this, or is this all just about tourism dollars, potentially?
No, Geoff, thanks for having me.
And
Cal, I don't necessarily think any space ride is normal or, you know, everyone is extraordinary. But I think there is more to it than just tourism. I think certainly some people want to go there to experience this, just to look out the window and look at the Earth and experience some weightlessness. But there also is a scientific component to it. They have flown these flights previously where they did have experiments on board. Some of my students at Columbia, I teach there as well, have put experiments into space on the Blue Origin vehicle, similar to what Jeff Bezos is going to be riding on next week. So there certainly is a lot of research that can be done, exploration that can be done, and also tourism. So I think it is more than just tourism, though, for sure.
And you mentioned the Jeff Bezos flight, which I think is set for next Tuesday. What should we expect there? How will that be different than what Richard Branson did?
Well, what you saw with Richard Branson's model with his company, what they're doing is taking off from a runway with the mothership, being dropped, going into space, and then landing back on a runway. Jeff Bezos is going to do it a little more traditionally with a rocket. The name of that spacecraft is New Shepard, which is named after Alan Shepard. So it's going to mimic that flight of the first American into space, suborbital flight, blast off, come back after about 11 minutes or so. So it's going to be a different way of getting there. There are, I think, advantages and disadvantages to each. But I think what's cool is that they both are very different, offer different experiences and different ways to experience space travel.